This is the Roland MS-1 digital sampler. It was released in 1995, and we're going to go over some of its basic functions today. First off, you have your DC 9 volt in. This thing will also run off 6 AA batteries, though, which is wonderful. Makes it portable. Your on-off switch here, so you can see the LCD screen will light up. Also, you have your mic inputs, stereo and mono, which you'll have options to change in the LCD screen. We'll go over in a moment. RCA inputs for line sampling. I have a iPod hooked up to that today. We're going to show you how to do that. And then RCA outputs, which I have going to a bass amp currently. There's also an option for a foot switch, MIDI in, and MIDI out. Over on the left of the console here, we have a scroll bar. So you can see the volume next to the bank rises as I decreases as I move that. You can also change values with that, which we will show you later on. Headphone jack and also memory card slot. I have in here currently a 32 MB PCM CIA card. These used to be extremely hard to find. It took me about 10 years to find it, but you can get them on eBay now. So, let's go into some basic pad functions. First off, I have the banks cleared right now. We have bank A and B, which are the internal memory. C, D, and E are all contained within the memory card. In banks A and B, you can play up to 4 samples at once. You have a much more sampling time in banks C, D, and E with the memory card, but the downfall of those is you can only play 1 sample at once. It's great, though, for backing tracks and longer loops that are going behind. So basically, you can have a maximum of 5 pads functioning at once. First thing you're going to want to do is up here in the edit section, you have system, sample, and utility. We're going to want to start with system. Right here it's on pitch, which we will change later, but you can scroll up and down to change that. We're not going to need to mess with that now, but if you use the arrow to scroll over, you'll see it says grade standard. Basically, you have several options of recording speed, which equals quality. You have standard, plus and minus will change these, or the scroll panel again. Standard, high, long one, and long two. We're gonna start with standard for now. To get out of this screen, you will push exit. And to begin sampling, you're gonna wanna hit sampling, start, stop, record, yes. Hit that once, and it will give you the option to select the pad you'd like to sample to. Gonna select pad one. It looks like there was a sample in there. Delete sample, yes, there are multiple ways to delete samples, but for now we're just gonna do that. As you can see here, there's a gain, which is set at 6. Now, to check your sampling time that you have remaining, if you just use the arrow to scroll over, see the remaining time here. We have 28 seconds currently. That's on standard in the internal memory, which is not a whole lot. You're going to have to learn to be creative with this. But one of the things you can do is slow the samples down later to maximize time. You can also switch from stereo to mono. And by doing that, you want to scroll over again. Here we have the options of what you're recording in with. I have it set to mic right now, but we're also going to do line. I also have it set to mono to save recording time when you do stereo. Basically, you're doubling what time you'll use. So I have connected to this currently a Sony cardioid pattern dynamic mic, and we're going to use this just to grab some simple samples. Scroll back over to gain, and you can see that the level rises there. And if I get really loud, it starts peaking out there, which happens with an asterisk. And you can have the asterisk flash at times, but you don't want it to be completely on, basically. So we're going to grab a sample, and to do that, you'll want to push start recording, and I will talk into the mic.
Loop pool.
Now, to stop that, you just hit it again. You may have noticed when I did that, the memory bar came up, and that's basically just a visual indication of how much time left you're dealing with. Now, to go into editing this particular sample, we're going to go into the edit mode sample function here. A1 is selected. And you have three options here. You have gate, which basically means it just goes as long as you hold it down. Now, you also have trigger function.
Loop pool.
Now, to stop that,
loop pool.
Which will make it loop endlessly.
Stop that,
loop pool.
Until you hit it again. Now, if you change that to drum,
loop pool.
It's going to play just once through. All that's fine. We're going to change it to trigger so it endlessly loops. And then we're going to scroll over further. It's loop, start, and end point, but we'll go over that in a more advanced tutorial. And here we have start point. Now, we want to basically trim off the beginning and ends of this sample so that it's clean and loops perfectly. We'll get it started right here.
Now, to stop that,
loop pool.
And we have a little bit too much on the beginning and end. Sometimes it's easier to start with the end point, so I'm going to scroll over here to end point, and you see this is in milliseconds. We're going to shave that down using the scroll bar here, but you can also use the plus and minus.
Now to stop that,
loop pool.
Now to stop that,
loop pool.
Now to stop that.
You can also use this arrow to go over and shave off bigger sections.
Loop pool.
Now to make
loop pool.
Now to make
loop pool.
Now make
loop pool.
Looks like we've got the majority of the end cut off there.
Loop pool.
So we're going to go back to the start point
loop
and shave
pool
off a little bit as well.
Loop pool. 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 Loop pool.
There's a little bit of breath in there, and it looks like it's sitting somewhere in the end, so we're just going to trim a little bit more off.
Loop pool. Loop pool.
All right, now we have loop the sample pool where we want it, basically.
Loop pool.
And we will exit to get out of there. You'll see it stops playing the sample. Now, an important function of the sampler, when you have trimmed the edges off of that sample, basically the start and end times that we removed are still there at the moment, but we want to get them out of there because we want to have more sampling time as we go along. If you go into utility, you have the option to delete A1, which we don't want to do. That's the other way to delete. And to do that, you would just hit yes. But we're going to scroll over to truncate A1. Truncation is basically removing the bits that we have silenced for the moment. So we're going to hit yes. Keep power on for the moment. Now it's finished. And now that sample will just run as a basic loop with the beginning and end cut off. And we'll run until we stop it. Now we want to try and sample offline. We're going to use the iPod today. So I'm going to go to sample and select pad 2. And what we're going to have to do, again, is one, you can look over. You see we have 26 seconds left. We've used 2 seconds of sampling time up to this point. Now we're going to scroll over to the in because we have the iPod going in on the input RCA here. We're going to change mic by hitting plus to line. And then again, you can scroll over and change that to stereo if you like. We're going to just keep it in mono for today, though. So back to the gain. Going to hook up the iPod here. Here we have a record that Onirathopter and I made. Now we're going to try and grab a snippet of this beat. But as you can see, the gain is not quite set high enough. So we're going to raise that, and we're still not getting a decent signal out of it. So there we go. Raise the volume up a little bit. And we're going to grab a snippet of that. That should do. All right, now, like we did before, we're going to go into sample. We're going to select pad 2. And we're going to scroll over, we're at the end point here, we're going to scroll over until we change this to a trigger, so it will run continuously. I'll do for now, I'm just going to turn the volume down a bit so we can hear ourselves. Alright, now we have our sample running. And it looks like we lucked out with a fairly clean loop already, so we're not going to need to do too much editing. Now, because we can have two pads playing at once, I'm going to introduce the other sample on top of this. But it's a little too quiet at this point, so I'm going to stop both samples. And we're going to go into sample again. We're going to choose pad 2. And we're going to go over past endpoint to sample volume. We can turn this one down, and it won't turn down as the sample's playing, but once we stop it and begin it again, you'll be able to tell there's a volume difference. So I'm going to take this down to about 50 or 45, to see if the sample volume matches up between them now. You can exit out of this menu, and let's try them both. Now basically we have two samples running at once. And you can change between pad functions if you want this to work like a drum machine with single hits or continuous loops like we're working with now. Something fun to do is go into system, and we're at standard right now. If you change this down, we'll just go to long 2 to show you the extreme differences between these. Exit out of this menu and then listen to what these loops sound like now. Basically, it gives you kind of a digital erosion as well as slowing the sample down. So you can alternate between the 4 speeds in the system menu here. And you can go up to high, which will speed up the sample, and this is the highest quality you can sample at. The one downfall of this function is you'll only be able to use one pad at a time. As you see, when you switch from one sample to the next, it'll actually kill the other one. And then when you're dealing on other speeds, you can have up to 4 of these going at once, and once you get to the 5th, the first button pushed will be the sample that drops off. Well, that'll be all for today as basic sampling functions and speed changes. In a later tutorial, we are going to go over sequencing and some of the more advanced functions of the Roland MS-1 digital sampler.